What are some deeply unsettling facts that you know? In 1933, a doctor named Karl Tanzler raided the tomb of a female patient with whom he'd become obsessed and stole her body. He lived with the corpse for 7 years. As the body fell apart, he attached the corpse's bones together with wire and coat hangers and fitted the face with glass eyes. He was only caught when someone saw him dancing with the corpse in front of an open window. After the bombing of Hiroshima, black rain that contained radioactive material fell, and many didn't realize it until it was too late. Also, according to my Japanese professor, they didn't even have a word for the atomic bomb at the time. I unfortunately can't remember what she said they called it instead. All whales eventually lose the energy to surface for oxygen, so they basically just sink and drown. These are known as whale falls. A whale will fall down to the ocean depth, its carcass creating a transitional ecosystem for the critters below. It's a rich ecosystem. New species of marine life have been discovered by observing these whale falls. It's a great example of the circle of life. In the Battle of Verdun, over 1 million artillery shells were fired onto a 19-mile wide stretch of land in the first 12 hours. If you were lucky enough to survive until then, the sound alone was enough to drive you insane. The astonishing fatality rates that can be found in so many battles in the First World War weren't accidents or unfortunate byproducts of the technology. They were factored into the battle plans. By the nature of attritional warfare, it was calculated how many men would be lost every week, and commanders drew up enough reinforcement to replace them. This was called normal wastage. I remember reading about the German plan at Verdun. The idea was to attack a target the French couldn't afford to abandon and force them to throw more and more men into the meat grinder to hopefully deplete the French army. It almost worked to some regiments of. The French army reported an over 100% casualty rate. Edit, I'm gonna chuck this here, since so many people are asking. It's possible for the casualty rate to be over 100% because when men die or become wounded, they get replaced to keep the unit at full strength. And if those men become casualties as well, it's possible for a unit of say 1,000 men to suffer 1,200 casualties over a particularly long and bloody battle like Verdun. If I remember correctly, Falkenhayn's original plan was just to take Verdun, as it was indeed an important piece of the French defensive apparatus. After it failed, he was like, meh, I just wanted to see them suffer anyway. But the attack was indeed a failure. Germany's mistake in this battle was to always leave the same troops in Verdun. If you were a Lancer in Verdun on 18th of February and didn't get killed or injured, chances were you stayed there until 21st of November. France, on the other hand, constantly swapped divisions, moving in fresh troops for a few weeks, then moving them back in a quieter part of the front. Once the men were worn out by the fighting, around 70% of all poilus at least spent some time in Verdun. Paradoxical undressing. It happens during the last stages of hypothermia, as your nerves are damaged. The person removes all of their clothing in freezing temperatures because they feel irrationally hot. An injury to the brain can turn you into a completely different person, as well as removing your ability to comprehend that it did. It doesn't even have to be a particularly bad one either. It just has to hit the right part of your brain. I was thinking about Michael Schumacher recently and this came to mind. My dad had brain surgery for a tumor and his personality changed immediately. He lost all his social rules and became the friendly, joking, gregarious salesman he'd always been at work. But without any of the depth of personality, he remembered everything and still did research for almost a year after that. But his social rules and any kind of deep personality were just gone. Doctor called it compensating for the loss by filling in with the salesman bullshit. And that's a very salesman thing to do. I've been in sales for 35 years and know the drill. It was hard on mom to take care of him because, as she said, this is not my husband. This is the salesman people see when he's away from me. Shit eventually went to more normal brain cancer sickness and he eventually passed after a year. It was so weird to watch and know that there was a whole part of him that the surgeon scooped out that day. Japan did some horrible experiments on people during World War II. Unit 731, vivisection, shattering people's frostbitten limbs, biological warfare, etc. It's all quite horrific, and don't recommend anyone without a stomach for horror to read about it. Also, after the war, the people who ran it were never tried as war criminals, because the US decided to keep them and their research under wraps so that they could get a hand up on the Soviets. Fun fact. In China today, where these experiments happened, when a room is messy, instead of saying it looks like a pigsty, they'll say it looks like the Japanese invaded. Ex-parents to child, clean your room. It looks like the Japanese invaded in here. In extreme cases of scurvy, your scars break down and old wounds are open. Collagen keeps scars together, and that collagen maintains itself throughout our lives. But without vitamin C, that process begins to halt and the collagen breaks down. Eat your fruits and veggies, folks. The weirdest thing about scurvy is how it's showing up in well-off people. Some modern diets cut out all fruits and vegetables, leading to very low vitamin C. People then start getting weird symptoms, like bleeding gums. There was a guy at my mate's uni who subsisted on nothing but cheese and bacon rolls and cheap cordial for a semester. Went to the doc. Doc took ages to diagnose him, because, naturally, who the duck gets scurvy in the middle of Brisbane, Australia, in the 21st century? Edit yes. I'm well aware of the urban legend. That also doesn't preclude it from happening in real life. If you're telling me that it's an urban myth that uni students have shitty nutrition, well, plus I met the guy, Scurvy Bob. He ducking hated the name Bob instead of his preferred diminutive Rob. But, let's face it, Bob sounded more 18th century piratical. He was fine with the scurvy bit. And the stupidest thing is, it takes literally any amount of vitamin C to halt. And the scariest thing is, scurvy doesn't just reopen scars, broken bones that have healed will unknit too. Several years ago, I was recovering from surgery on my leg, one of many, and I had an external fixation on my leg. Basically a metal cage with 9 metal pins anchored in my bone and coming out and connected to the cage. I was adjusting the thing daily to basically regrow bone to heal a bad break. So those pin sides were moving. I have lots of, well, 9 teardrop shaped scars on my leg now. I was 100% non-weight bearing and couldn't do much cooking. So lots of frozen meals and food ordered in. And then at one point in my recovery, the level of pain in my leg exploded. And those pin sites and the other incision sites all started to reopen and weep. I was freaking out, calling my doc, doubling up on my pain meds, etc. And then I came across an article about scurvy, some kid that had gotten it freshman year of college after ingesting nothing but fried chicken and beer. I drank a very large glass of orange juice and felt better within like 30 minutes. It's such an easy fix that it should be the first treatment given for certain symptoms. Look, it's not scurvy because duh, but just in case it is scurvy, here is some odge. Drink that up while we finish your intake paperwork. How fast can scurvy set in? Obviously your situation made any early symptoms of scurvy very clear. But for the average person, it's probably the furthest thing from their options when things start going awry. Also, it's definitely unsettling to think we are just a big fleshy patchwork of collagen fibers holding our bits together, and it can all easily come unstitched if left unchecked. In the 1800s, a lot of dentures were made using the teeth of dead soldiers. People used to scavenge battlefields pulling the teeth from the dead. After the Battle of Waterloo, it was advertised that the teeth were from the battle, like it was a novelty. And if I remember correctly, there were so many teeth available after Waterloo that scavenging for teeth was no longer profitable for those in Europe anyways. Terminal lucidity is the return of mental clarity or memory or consciousness shortly before death. This happens to around 10% of people with dementia. My grandma was in a care facility for the last year of her life due to dementia. My uncle and mom have a bad relationship and were arguing in her room over what needed to be done for her, and she yelled at them in the most conscious manner, "Chuck, Heidi, stop fighting this instant," and then passed right there. She didn't recognize any of us for weeks before this. Good to know why that happened. The symptoms for a heart attack can be a lot milder than what is shown in movies or TV shows. I have seen people coming in with some discomfort and then passing due to a massive infarction when we did the angiogram. Quite a few years ago, my grandma took my grandpa to see his GP, and while at his appointment, the doctor noticed the symptoms of a heart attack on my grandma. The doctor had her sent to the emergency room. She had a massive heart attack, and she said she only felt a mildly nauseous. She's most likely only alive because the GP used to be a cardiothoracic surgeon, but gave it up to be a small town doctor. If a hamster manages to get its hands on your body, if you are dead, it will use chunks of your skin, hair and other stuff to make a nest, leaving a very bloody and messy scene behind. Seemingly 100% healthy people with literally no reason to believe they would have any reason to can still spontaneously drop dead. Cherish every day. Had a friend who was in a Pokemon Go group chat with me who just up and died. We were talking about the event that was going on, and he stopped responding. Everyone thought he was just busy and carried on the conversation without him. A few hours later, someone in the chat said he died. Just walked into his kitchen and fell over dead. Everyone named a Ho-Oh after him, since that was his Pokemon Go buddy. It was the first time a lot of us had experienced sudden death like that. So we were all really shaken for a while. He was only in his mid-30s. The real world process of human fertilization, that is. Not in labbies, so random that just about anything that happened differently during and after your parents having sex would have resulted in someone else or no one being born instead of you. Rainbow Valley at Mount Everest is named so because of the colorful coats of dead people. The Blue Mustang statue at the Denver airport, named Blue Cipher by the locals, killed its creator when a piece fell and severed an artery in his leg. If weird ghost stuff is happening, make sure your carbon monoxide detector is working. Cows don't convert grass directly into protein. They have enormous colonies of bacteria in their stomachs that have population explosions when they eat grass, live, breed, die, and then the cows digest them into protein. The guy that started the vaccines cause autism scare in the late 90s condoned and conducted child abuse as part of his fraudulent study, all in the pursuit of fabricating evidence to support his own business ventures and a class action lawsuit against MMR vaccine manufacturers. My mother saw no end of disturbing things when she was a nurse circa late 1950s 1960s. She worked on psych wards, where people got disturbing treatments, lobotomies, sleep therapy, etc. She also worked on a pediatrics ward in an area where there was pretty wild poverty and the kids were in rough shape, awful era and living conditions way back when. That are best ISO standard models and data for high voltage electrocution to the human body necessary for my field. I work on EVs. Comes from two main sources of information: one, data from livestock inadvertently touching power lines or electrified railroads, and two, from a whole bunch of German scientific papers dated between 1942 and 1945. Multiple genetic diseases. And this is extremely oversimplified, so I don't give people nightmares. Glass bones, brittle bone disease, sneezing, can break a bone, or bumping a counter. Basically, the body can't grow strong bones at all. CPS has been called on many a parent for this disease before diagnosis. Harlequin syndrome, very very cracked and broken skin due to what doctors believe is the body being unable to shed old skin easily. Stone man syndrome, body overreacts to injury, and instead of a bruise or sore muscle, will turn the injured area into bone. After a certain point, people with this have to decide what position to be frozen in for the rest of their existence. Tree man syndrome, condition where the HPV to grow uncontrollably to the point that the skin starts looking like tree bark. Butterfly skin, you know how delicate a butterfly's wings are and how easily they can lose their wing scales. That's the skin of someone who has this. It just comes off at the slightest touch, leaving many patients to look like walking mummies and needing to be under insane amounts of sun protection. Vampire disease, basically, if someone goes out in sunlight without enough protection, their skin reacts horribly, worse than a sunburn by at least 20x. Edit, thank you for the awards, lovely strangers. And to people who might wonder how the heck I came up with this list, well, when you do research for your own medical problems, are fascinated by emergency room stories, and are still wondering why some of the human body glitches exist, you come across a lot. Definitely gives you a hard slap to the face and more sympathy, especially if you meet people like these in the wild. Makes it easier to look at them as people instead of WTF their genetic lottery decided to do. Heya, I have brittle bones, osteogenesis imperfecta. I broke my femur, the strongest bone in the human body, by being pushed into a bin. It ducking sucks not being able to play sports with your friends or be rough with them, because you know, if you do you'll end up with an express trip to the hospital. So much stuff is cut off because I don't wanna risk breaking something, and it honestly ducking sucks. Won't wish this on my worst enemy. In 2018 my sister was murdered. We know who did it. We keep track of where he lives. He has moved 4 times since my sister disappeared. The police also know he did it. There's not enough evidence to bring him in or charge him. Her body has still never been found. If I go after him, he becomes a victim, and I won't be able to be a father to my children. He gets to be alive every day. He's a serial rapist. We suspect my sister was not his first murder. From our interactions with state police and FBI, my impression is that our situation, while a nightmare, is perhaps not as rare as you would normally assume or hope. Thanks for watching. Consider subscribing for more videos.